this week, Mitt Romney has made it official in the last week or so that he is running for Senate in the state of Utah. And Donald Trump decided to go ahead and endorse Mitt Romney. And this is actually a pretty big deal. Romney and Donald Trump have not been, I guess, super best friends over the last few years. But nevertheless, Donald Trump earlier this week tweeted out the following. At Mitt Romney has announced he is running for the Senate from the wonderful state of Utah. He will make a great senator and worthy successor to at Orrin Hatch and has my full support and endorsement. Not too long after that, Mitt Romney replied, "Thank you, Mr. President, for the support. I hope that over the course of the campaign, I also earn the support and endorsement of the people of Utah." Which is very weird for Mitt Romney to say, "Thank you for the endorsement," which means he accepts the endorsement, because not long ago, Mitt Romney tweeted out the following. If Trump had said 4 years ago the things he says today about the KKK, Muslims, Mexicans, disabled, I would not have accepted his endorsement. So what's changed, Mitt Romney? Donald Trump's stance on the KKK, Muslims, Mexicans, and the disabled hasn't changed in the last year. So why suddenly are you willing to accept his endorsement? And more importantly, Mr. Romney, have you been paying attention? Have you seen what's happened to the candidates that Donald Trump has openly and publicly and on Twitter endorsed? Typically, in the last year, hasn't really worked out well for them. And yet here you are accepting Donald Trump's endorsement as if all of his past sins were suddenly forgiven. Because let's not forget that in 2016, March of 2016, actually, Mitt Romney gave a speech urging Republican voters in the primaries to not vote for Donald Trump. And then on the exact same day that Romney said that, Trump came out to remind his supporters that Romney begged for his endorsement. And Donald Trump said, "I could have said, Mitt, drop to your knees, but I didn't." And so very odd thing to say for Donald Trump. Not sure what he was trying to imply there. But nevertheless, there is a massive history of feuding between these two men. So it is odd, one, that Romney would accept the endorsement from Donald Trump, given the fact that Donald Trump clearly still doesn't meet up with Mitt Romney's endorsement criteria. But more importantly, that Donald Trump would even come out and endorse Mitt Romney to begin with. What could possibly be his motivation for wanting to endorse Mitt Romney? Well, there's a very simple explanation for it. Donald Trump understands that with Orrin Hatch retiring from the Senate, that is potentially an open seat that Republicans could very easily lose. So, if Republicans lose that, if they lose 3-4 Senate seats, that Senate flips to the Democrats. And what is one of the most important things that the Senate does, aside from their day-to-day duties? They're the ones who vote if impeachment passes the House. They vote whether or not to convict a president and remove them from office. That is what Donald Trump is so terrified of. You know, in Nixon's final days, he had an aide that would go to the Senate every day and basically do a tally of who in the Senate would vote to remove Nixon from office. He would report to Nixon. Nixon would say, "Do I have the numbers?" And every day the aide would say, "Yes, yes, yes." And then finally, that one day where the aide came back and said no, that's when Nixon resigned from office. Trump does understand the importance of the Senate, and even losing one seat, two seats maybe, you're talking about a complete different party controlling that. And we all know how Donald Trump has treated the Democrats, so it's unlikely that they would go, you know, easy on him. Not to mention the fact that the coming blue wave that is expected for the House of Representatives this coming November is not going to bode well for impeachment to begin with. But if he retains that Senate, if the Republicans do, then yeah, it's going to be a lot less likely that he would get voted out of office if impeachment passes the House. And so that's what this is all about. So suddenly, Donald Trump wants to pretend like he never said Mitt Romney came begging like a dog, which he did say. So instead, he wants to be Mitt Romney's best friend. They want to be buddies. Mitt Romney wants to accept his endorsement, even though, yeah, he said some pretty nice things about the KKK while saying pretty disgusting things about Muslims and disabled people and African Americans and immigrants and pretty much everybody else you can imagine. But that won't stop Romney from accepting the endorsement. And hopefully, like so many other candidates that we've seen run for office in the last year, that endorsement by Donald Trump is a kiss of death. It means that Mitt Romney will not succeed in his campaign to win that Senate seat from the state of Utah. And hopefully, with a little luck, the Democrats will get their act together in enough time to take the 2018 midterms for both the House and the Senate. But in order to do that, and I know the polling still shows generic Democrat up double digits against generic Republican, but they're not going to be able to do that until they come up with a clear and concise message. They need a good platform. Right now, the Democrats do not have a solid platform. They're too busy trying to find their leader. You know, who's going to be the person to take charge of the party? Well, you don't need that. You don't need it if you have a unified message that every single person can go out there as a member of the party, as somebody running for office under that banner, if they're all on the same page. Because when they're all on the same page, when they are all giving that same message, saying this is what we'll do, the voters have more faith in it. You can't have people out there like Joe Manchin saying, oh, my party's too obsessed with climate change. We got to knock that off and we got to give subsidies to the coal industry. No, that undermines the message of the rest of the Democratic Party. And you're not going to win by saying that you're not Donald Trump. It didn't work out very well in the 2016 election. It's certainly not going to work out well in this year's midterm elections. The Democrats have flipped too many seats in special elections in the last year to screw it up at the finish line. And I know we're only in February, but believe me, November is going to come a lot faster than we think. Democrats need to get it together, because if they can do that, if they can get it together, if they can get that unifying message, taking back the House and the Senate in this year's midterms is going to be a piece of cake. I'm Farron Cousins. I'm sitting in for Sam Cedar today. We'll be right back with more Ring of Fire Radio.